اصطفاه الواحد الحي كذا المليك.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع اليه سبيلا ومن كفر فان الله غني عن العالمين. صدق الله العظيم. Respected brothers and sisters, it is an honor for all of us to participate in the lesson of Hajj. Hajj is an important journey. Hajj is a journey that is required to be learned and to know how it must be performed and how it will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many brothers and sisters are here, mostly they understand Urdu, but there are brothers who can't understand English. Okay, alhamdulillah. This is the first presentation. Just take image or imagine of the Hajj in the past, present and the future. Then we will come to the point, how it is performed, what is the meaning of Hajj, what is the virtues and the rights of Hajj, and how it is performed. From Hong Kong to Makkah al-Mukarramah, and then Medina, and then you will come back, inshallah, step by step, whatever the time we have. This is not the real picture. Imagine, it is the beginning of Baitullah. Then the people start to stay and live there, because Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was asked to take your family and stay there. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam left Hazrat Hajira or Hazrat Hajar and son Hazrat Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, and Hazrat Ibrahim left them in Makkah, then went to Palestine, traveled from Iraq. وَقَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. So this is the beginning. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, what is the first Allah's house on the surface of earth? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Baitullah, Masjid al-Haram. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, what was after it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Masjid al-Aqsa. So this is the history of the most sacred places on the surface of earth. So some ahadith or some narration spoke that the first it was built by angels to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it was built by Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. Then it was rebuilt on the same foundation by Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Quran says, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. So this image is just the life of Hazrat Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam and the time of Hazrat Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. Then I think it is about 150 years back, this was the Baitullah and Haram, and this is the real picture. Then population increase. This is about 100 years back. This is 1297. 1297 means this is 1439 year, Hijra. So this is more than 140 years. Sometime, and it Baitullah has the history, it was damaged with the flood. Even in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was demolished due to the flood and rebuilt. And the original foundation that had Baitullah. It was not the square that today we see. It was the shape like, in Urdu say, mustatil. And it had two doors. But in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's time, but he was, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not announce his prophethood. At that time, the people of Makkah, they collected money with certain condition. So what they could collect, so they built on this shape and this form. So the place that is left without building, that is today called Hatim. It was the part of Baitullah. So it was left. Then Hazrat Abdullah ibn Zubair Raziallahu ta'ala anhu rebuilt in his time and covering the whole part. Then after Hazrat Abdullah ibn Zubair, then Banu Umayyah built on the same foundation. Then Hazrat Imam Malik gave the fatwa, it should not be made a toy in the hand of rulers. So now it must not be changed. So from that day till today, it is the same foundation, same form, and same shape. This was the door Maqam-e-Ibrahim that is near Baitullah, even today exists, but it is now in a small shape, small size. This is Zamzam. It was also exist even today when you make the tawaf. So it is in Mataf, the place where you make the tawaf. It was there at that time. But now, because of the crowd, it cannot be maintained. So it has been removed. And the well of the Zamzam is under the floor of Mataf. This is current picture. Aerial picture inside Baitullah. This is the pillars inside. So this is the image of inside Baitullah. Hajri Aswad, the future plan. They are planning, I think they have started the work on it, the whole area of Baitullah and Masjid-e-Haram that would be covered with the umbrella. The future would be like this. The train will come on every side and they will drop hajis near Haram, near Baitullah. But inside, you can see. This is the picture of train, the future. This is the old, we say, shaitan or jamarat. Actual word is jamara. So it was the jamara, only this size. This is today. This is Medina, old. This again, more than 100 years old picture. This is a market. Babur Rahma. Shari al-Huyayna, Masjid-e-Quba. And Hujjaj, today you have different vehicles. The people who are not capable to walk, nowadays we are using. But in the past, it was the way to. And I have seen myself when first time I went in 1992. It was the people, some people, they used to carry the on their shoulder and they do the tawaf. This is today Masjid-e-Nabawi, Rauza Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Masjid-e-Nabawi. This is the picture of Rauza Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Actually, you will come from this. This is the place where Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's grave there. And the face of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to this direction. and then Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq and Hazrat Umar. So you will pass like this and you will say Salat and Salam upon Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then you will say Assalamu Alaika Ya Abu Bakr Siddiq Raziallahu Ta'ala An Khalifata Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then Hazrat Umar Farooq Raziallahu Ta'ala An. This is the future plan of Medina. Future would be Masjid Nabawi like this. Huge building will be built around Baitullah, Masjid Nabawi. Towers. This is our old picture. Masjid, it was, it is Arafah. This is also Jabal Rahmat.
واجبنا الله تعالى انزله ورسوله.